I'm gonna go back to Drow. I think, like, even the last month, they just constantly pick Drow every single time first phase, and sometimes they like to sneak it in. Even, like, last game, I felt like they just switched around the Drow completely with the Keeper of Light last phase. It's like, okay, we didn't know whether or not it was gonna be, like, the support or the offlane Brewmaster, just because we really never see that hero, and I think they could be throwing a curveball.
I mean, this could help us identify a bit more, though, as far as what Wings plan to do. A Skywrath Mage, the third pick, has been a go-to for some of the teams as a Timbersaw counter. They just favor a lot of silence.
I love it. It's like, we spoke about it in the bus before. It's like a really hard Timbersaw counter, and he's like one of the only support heroes that can really...
There we go. We were not blessed last TI with any sort of pudge. This time, Wings, do us the honor here. And then I happen to notice Misery smirked a bit at that one.
The second time they pick pudge, right?
Yes.
Yep. Yes.
Yep.
So what does the pudge do here? And what do Wings do to utilize this pudge to make it something that they can continuously pull out in drafts at the most highest caliber tournament on the planet?
I feel like they can do one of two things. It's usually... He's actually a very strong lane support. Because if you get hooked and you have one level in Rot and any other kill potential on a hero, you just pressure the lane so much. So it's good if you think the enemy might go dual offlane, but it's also good to pressure the offlane or the enemy safe lane as well. You can do the same thing. You can just send him plus one other hero, and it's just, you're against a Luna, right? You either force the Kunkka and the Shadow Demon to stay bottom to protect against the Pudge plus whatever hero they're going to be sending offlane on Wings, and then it's just that pressure constantly from a Pudge. And when he's missing during the mid game, Wings random hook hits, it can just be a kill.
It's kind of like a... right? Like, yeah. You have to completely change the way you play the game. And I like it for another reason, because they have Pudge plus Skywrath. If Pudge ever gets a blink, they can pretty much solo kill any core. Like, those two heroes can kill any core, as well as the Naga Sirenet. You can just ult on top of that with the Skywrath, and you can get a super easy hook on that. You can even hook sleep targets out of the sleep, and then they're like super separated. You can just kill one core off at a time.
Reserve time.
Not that good against SD Luna, though. Like, SD in general, like, very good against...
I think it's more about the lane, and if you land a hook when the enemy team is 5-manning, you can still potentially fight off of it.
Although, Wings, if they really get into the late game with the Luna Siege, I think they're gonna have a lot of problems.
That is true, yeah. But it's also something to be said, like, DC, pick Luna SD, you can still play a very early 5-man style if you want to try to just get the map control away and prevent the Naga from getting to that, like, critical point in the game. So it really depends. I think they're a little bit more flexible than what Wings are right now.
So Ben, as a Wings fanboy...
What? Already? We just started, it's day number one! Pudge and Techies already!
Alright, boys.
Wings deliver.
Try to go high ground. Really.
Ever?
Ever. Ever.
Ever.
Toby not cast at one of the games. We're like, wow, this would be a really good Techies lane. They had Pudge, they had Magnus, they had Rubick, and they deliver.
Wow.
That makes it 102, right?
So is this like Techies Pudge offlane?
I don't know.
I mean, that's the first thing that I thought of.
It's a support. Part of
yeah. That's... new for when something a bit more to say as we throw things over.
I'm going for Wings.
I mean, I have to go for Wings. I just love what I see here.
Also Wings. Techies all the way.
It's hard not to love their draft, is it? Let's go ahead and see what the casters think. They better be pumped about this one. Let's throw it over to them right now. It's LD and Mott. Gentlemen, take it away.
Well, what do you say? You got a Pudge, you got a Techies. Nobody expected this. LD, it's hype time. What do you think?
This is Wings. You don't know what to expect. Expect the unexpected. If anyone was going to pick Techies at the main event, it was always going to be Wings. If anyone was going to pick Pudge, it was definitely going to be them. Some cute combos, but honestly, I have no idea. We have not seen Techies in competitive Dota. That, in theory, is a big advantage for Wings, but generally, when you haven't seen a hero at all, it's good Wings to prove us wrong, and it looks like it will be an offlane Techies. Faith Beyond the man to play it. Already TPing. Where's he going to start getting to work? He has skilled the landmine, so we're not going to see any level 1 Suicide Squad shenanigans. What's he up to here?
I feel like this could either go extraordinarily well for Wings or, well, maybe...
extraordinarily poorly.
Yeah.
It could be a very quick game. If the Techies pick backfires, Pudge in the mid game as a support that can snowball, but if he has a bad start, doesn't really offer that much, it could be a disaster.
It's going to be the Torrent. Innocent caught out, it looks like, and he will fall. That's going to be your first blood going the way of DC, so already a good start for their squad.
I was trying to do the hero introductions here. Relax, DC.
They really wanted to make sure they dealt with all of these heroes quickly.
So, a jungle techies, I guess. And a bunch of mines at the camp for now. Boy canning out nearby. Wonder how much Wings have practiced this particular strategy. We're going to find out real soon.
This is super interesting to me. Faith Beyond, he's going to be able to at least take down some of these camps here. This doesn't block. All chat starting off the day the way it should.
I've heard Wayne's like to all chat a lot in scrims, and they are known for their trash talk. Actually, a bit NA Dota-esque in the way that they will start the game with, often be kind of mocking and teasing their opponents for any mistakes they make. So, starting with five heroes bottom, they have nobody on the top side of the map.
This is a completely open safe lane. There is nobody here.
The abandon your safe lane strat. I have never seen this before.
What's going on?
Is this a real game?
This isn't Dota. I don't know what this is. Soxa's sitting here waiting for a disruption. Little does he know there's nobody up here. They're aggro tri-laning.
Their counter to the aggro tri-lane is just not to lane anyone top. Faith Beyond, instant level 2, the first kaboom of this TI. And instead, Mott, they're going bottom. Ice is there as the Pudge. I really think they need level 2 to have an easy kill in this lane, but not going to be an easy lane for the Timbersaw.
Like they said, Rot obviously, but they're going to go for it anyways. The Rot coming out and move. He can deal with physical damage. He cannot deal with the magical damage. He will fairy fire. What a torrent from Misery! Ice, he'll go down!
And now the good luck, have
fun!
Well, wow. A dose of NA Dota in North America. How fitting. Techies, now that he has his level 2, is going to go to the top lane. He has Suicide Squad, so if he gets caught out, he can always Suicide and deny the opponents a bit, but they're moving on to Misery bottom. Great body block from Y. They don't have poke yet, and the torrent again connecting.
What a start to this game.
Well, running a bit of a cheese strat here, giving up those two early kills, not the way you want to begin the game.
No, definitely not. I feel like Faith Beyond, he's going to sit up here, and we'll see what kind of impact he has. I mean, again, he's only level 2. He does have Suicide Squad, so they might rotate him down bottom, see if they can kill Mu. But this tri lane, they should have gotten that kill to begin with. But again, a great rotation from Misery.
Fairy Fire too good. Else.
Yeah, that Fairy Fire as well. Great timing from Mu. And now he's level 2, so he's got Timber Chain, so if he needs to get out of a bad situation, he certainly can. And we'll see if that's going to be the case for Mu. Continue laning Ice, getting right-clicked by Misery a little bit. And no X marks just yet, though, for Kunkka.
So you're definitely showing poise here. A very unusual draft and opening strategy, but they don't fall prey to it. They carried the early TP on Misery, and he does come to the fight, salvages things, and makes it a big win. So looking at matchups now, Faith Beyond on the techies. They're going to leave the Luna alone here. The only way Luna really dies in this situation is if she gets caught very out of position. And walks into mines. But on her own, she's not in danger of dying. Maybe he lays a trap and then the Pudge comes and hooks her. But barring something like that, he's gonna farm.
What an arrow! He was barely in range of that citra. I don't think he was! Now down bottom, Ice, still in trouble. We'll miss that torrent. Looks like Mu's actually the one getting right-clicked out now, and Ice will be able to stay alive.
They don't have the silence yet, so killing Mu is very difficult, even with the level 1 Timber Chain. Dilly leaves level 3 here on Innocence. Instead, might look for Misery. They do have an ensnare, but moves up in front.
He's the body blocker, and he's going to be the bodyguard, getting the kill on the Pudge with the Whirling Death on a right click.
Never. All right, where's the all-chat well-played for Mu?
Top lane, there's an invis, at least Shadow Demon coming up here. Disruption's going to come through, and it's already starting with Resolution on that Luna. The illusions will go through. They'll try to clear out whatever mines are here. It's a great idea from the side of DC, and it looks like, well, there's no mines at least, so
yeah, that
doesn't really matter. It's
definitely an important point is that Shadow Demon is very annoying for techies, as you can just run illusions around to try and clear out traps. Later on in the game, maybe even a gem is on a hero at times, and you can use those True Sight illusions to scout out potential traps. So looking at the way the game's developing, it's a big concern for Wayne's. The Naga is not farming particularly well in the tri-lane. Timbersaw is already level 4, so that off-lane is a complete disaster. In the mid lane, Blink is only slightly ahead of the Invoker, who has gotten some help. And this is actually the other hero besides Meepo that he really rose to prominence on. He could take games over as Invoker. I don't feel like they have the best Invoker counters later on in the game. So So that's two lanes not going well. Now on top of that, Luna is your lead farmer. It is not a good start for Wings at all.
Sunstrike with the Shadow Poison Disruption. Sunstrike on top! And he does leap away just in time. Wings is able to get out. Blink will be able to move away.
So he's running for his life, and Invoker's free farming.
Three off, he had gotten four. That might have been a kill, but I don't think three is enough to do it. No, not even, I mean, especially with level one.
Only a level one Shadow Poison.
It will not do nearly enough damage.
And now with Timbersaw having the advantage, it gets a lot harder to kill him. Skyrath is the hero they need there if they want to go for kills. Still not seeing really much of a trap, just a, looks like a single landmine top. Doxa walks over a solitary one.
It tickles him a little bit, but there's another one in lane. He's gonna walk over and as he disrupts, maybe not. Torch sets this up as well, and the Sunstrike, boom! They will get the kill and they will lose their techies on Wings.
When they're confident, DC are confident enough to just come in and gank the techies. Normally techies lane is like the no-go zone. It's less so the case if the big change rework to mines after CI5, but they're still moving in. They're looking for another kill here top on Shadow. And with the turret, the nuke from the Luna, they will find it. Wings might be a very quick game one the way things are headed. Already trailing 2,000 gold, 1,500 experience. Not seeing techies offer much. He is leveling up Suicide Squad mod. A hook is probably an instant suicide kill because they really need to do something to shut down these cores.
This is not a great start for Wings. We don't have to say. We talked about it in the beginning of the game. They didn't get off to a fast start, and it was going to be trouble. At least Blink is farming well with 31 last hits, but again, the Luna also continues to do so for resolution. There's a free farm lane now for move down bottom, which is, of course, exactly what happened top lane at the beginning of this game. It just feels like Wings are rotating around every lane to try to find something. Maybe not mid just yet, but top lane, bottom lane, they weren't successful, obviously. Where do they go from here? What do they do? It looks like they're going to smoke up, but...
They're running a trio that wants to be getting kills. Pudge, techies, at this stage of the game, especially if you're going to max Suicide Squad or at least take 3 points in it right away, you want to convert this into hero kills. Slow down some of these scaling cores, kill the Invoker before he gets his Midas. Speaking of which, they are moving in mid, but if you don't do that, and at that point, the plan B for Wings is to just play the turtle game. They have a Naga, a Mirana, and a Tekkis. These heroes can crush waves for days, and in good news for them, their towers have not taken much damage, but Cross Exhort Invoker, Luna with Shadow Demon Illusions, they can push pretty hard, and they can push fairly safely, even against Tekkis traps. So Wings holding onto the outer towers, that's their big plan B if they can't find kills, but... Again, it's still a plan B. It's not the game plan they had in mind when they started this.
Good news is for Wings is that DC are going to have to spend a lot of money investing in sentries and trying to bring down mines as much as possible. It's at least something going the right. Down bottom, Face Beyond has rotated. Mu is trying to push this tier 1 tower. He's doing a pretty good job of it. Face Beyond's right clicks are not very good. But
now, bear in mind, Suicide Squad is physical damage. So against the Timbersaw with 25 plus armor right now, Techies is not the ideal target to be going for a kill. Let's have the remote mines now. He's going to start laying a trap. They leave four heroes top, so they abandoned mid lane. Wings just consistently abandoning lanes. But it's not like they're getting a farm advantage here, Mont. They're getting out-farmed by pretty much all the DC cores right now.
Yeah, I mean...
When is it going to change?
The one, again, bright spot again is going back to that Mirana, but I think Mirana has to start getting involved with arrows or just farming killer.
Moving top.
Torrent's going to connect. Shadow will be next. Lucent Beam, and he doesn't have Stalk. They miss out on the hook, unfortunately, from Ice Ice. Unlike Shadow will go, but...
You know, one thing I was going to mention, which the draft analyst didn't really touch on, is that Pucho can also be really strong defensively. If your ally's getting caught, like, Disruption Torrent, you know where they're going to be. Even the X, you can hook them out right after the X comes. Potentially a very good defensive spell, but hey, if you're hooking your own Skyrath who's not even being targeted, then that is not going to work. So there's some potential for the Pudge to turn these ganks around, but we're just not seeing it. Really nothing working for Wings with this unusual draft.
I mean, DC are the ones being aggressive against this lineup. The Sunstrike's going to hit. It looks like the Torrent will as well, and Innocent will barely survive right now. The Lucent Beam coming in. Link now with a hatred and a double damage through. Meanwhile, Soxa does get the kill. He will go down, but he does get the turret off before falling against that Skywrath Mage. And that Tier 1 tower, it does end up going down in that bottom lane as well. DC continue. Just roll over Wings.
And they're still looking to go on top. There is no song yet. Shadow, deal time for the gank Naga.
Sunstrike, can he get it done? No, Ice Ice will get the kill, but now back top. Shadow still in trouble.
Doesn't have Song, he's very close, Maud, he's gonna try to juke in the trees, oh. Resolution! Completely gets his ankles broken! And now, concussive shot, Net, can they turn on him?
Shadow's coming in, TP out, Resolution, he will be able Radiant's to make it away, nothing to stop that TP.
No Song yet. Still though, Eclipse, a very long cooldown as far as carry ultimates go, so nice job there by Wings. They're doing some of these little things right. They are still getting out farmed. Weeha did end up dying, and that is probably the ideal hero to be killing, especially since he hasn't gotten his Midas yet. Still waiting to see the techie's effect though. Often at least very good at stopping pushes. That's not really the case here, as his tower drops nice and early to the Timbersaw. Yet to see any suicides that result in kills, or really any impact at all from Faith Beyond whatsoever. So does grab the Soul Ring. It just lends credence to the idea that Wings are more counting on the techies, the turtle, stall the game and drag it super late with the Naga Siren. But is it a game where Naga and Mirana can carry? There's a lot of ways to do with Naga illusions. I'm not entirely sure that they can just rely on like, oh, we have auto late game against this team. Plus, really good scaling support, Shadow Demon, Kuka, Pudge. Yeah, in theory, he could scale with Fleshy, but he's not getting kills.
Just this aggression over the DC, they might not get the late game. It's Warren from Devil and the Sun to Shadow, luckily enough. We get to see Mu being involved in any of these kills from DC, with the exception of the early game fights down bottom. They'll go for the tower, they really want the tier 1, and they've done a good job of trying to focus down each tower individually. There are some heroes setting up defense in the top lane, looking to maybe wrap around and try to find a target, including that Skywrath Mage. But for now, everyone's sitting in the tree line here for Wings LD.
DC are just farming all three lanes. Their cores are pulling dramatically ahead now. Techie is with 29 CS, Naga with 43. All of the DC cores at 50 plus. You're going to win the farm war by default. Arrow, though, could change this. Nice juke there. Soxa, he just calmly walks back. And the arrow's not connecting. Who is going to take over and change the course of the game? Ice Ice, now level 7, has the max range hook. Pudge, Techies, they've been silent. These are heroes that need to find kills. Is this going to be the big moment for Ice Ice to take over? Radiant team lacking vision, but they've got 4 heroes top.
Smoke up Weeha is also up in the top lane.
They haven't skilled Song yet. He's gonna miss the hook. Wings, you gotta hit something.
They hit nothing there. Both arrow and hook not connecting either target. Faith Beyond TPing in, and it looks like Weeha's gonna set this up. Successful come through. Blink doesn't make it out in time. Blink not successful. Zoxa, he's gonna be the one to go down. But the ghost ship onto 2 with the Torn. A double kill for Weeha.
It's a slaughter, and they're looking for more. Sunstrike just barely missing on Faith Beyond. Get Formaunt. They lose only a Shadow Demon. That's without Mu. Mu's not even there. This hero might be their strongest at this stage of the game, and he's just farming bottom. Weeha going for the Midas, immediately back to the mid lane. This is turning into a train wreck.
Mu's like, I'm not fighting on my Bloodstone yet. Forget it. Hold on a second. Let me get that. I'll come back to you. Weeha has his Midas now, like you talked about. He's building into the drum, of course, with the Akil on top. So just this straight standard build for Aquatic Zord Invokers, and DC continued pressure. There's a couple of remote mines placed down, but really Faith Beyond has not done anything in terms of anything, actually. He's not even used his suicide squad once this game. He's not found any mines.
And he brought it to level 3. He invested a lot in it. Only the one point in stasis trap is catch a replay here. Ice Ice. The Eclipse comes out first. They had a Sentry Ward. They were ready for the Moonlight Shadow Initiation. That's something that we were able to catch DC off guard with quite a bit last game. So looking forward, DC, this is the dream gem game. You're up against the techies as well as Moonlight Shadow.
Yeah.
You can also easily just scout with the disruption illusions of any hero that has the gem. I think gem is a pretty hard counter to the Wings lineup.
I think you put it on Mu as well. I mean, maybe not a melee hero, but Mu is so tanky that it might not matter. Again, like you talked about with all that physical damage reduction with the armor coming out. Hook coming through again, missing for Faith Beyond. Or excuse me, Ice Ice rather. Faith Beyond on that techies. Now the disruption coming out. Strong combination, not there, but entertain it. Demonic Purge into Innocent.
Where's that hook? Come on, Ice Ice. Nice silence on Mu. And DC, there's really no need to force the issue here. They're out farming them. They feel confident in their late game. Blink, Axe is coming at an okay clip for the Mirana, but he's not finding kills. Pudge and Techies are basically not even heroes in this game, to be honest. As the two have combined for a 1-4 score. Techies, the other nice thing this hero offers is tower pressure, but we haven't seen that either. He's not been sieging towers. In fact, all the DC towers are at full HP, so really, is the techies doing? It's just not coming together for Wings.
Getting ready for late game. I don't know. That's all I can
say. Yeah, I mean, at this point, if you're Wings, you're looking at Murana Ags, Naga Radiance, Turtle. Try to stall with some pickoffs. Play for ultra late game because the laning stage long over at this point, and DC completely in the driver's seat.
Blink will send himself down to the bottom lane alongside two other heroes, Innocence and Ice Ice, backing him up. Ready to go with a hook, an ancient seal, Mystic Flare, whatever they can get. They don't even have Mystic Flare yet. No level 6 on the Scourath Mage, so they're also lacking in levels. And look at his net worth. He's only at 700. No boots yet for the Scourath Mage, so this is a rough game. That support, unfortunately.
That's okay. He's got above average base move speed. He's got the wind lace. No, that's pretty bad, though, if your Scourath still doesn't have boots in 15 minutes. Top tower
is under attack. It just feels like at every turn, DC outplaying them, outlaning them, finding kills.
And the plan Bs are limited for Wings. I mean, we see Murana walk into Roshan, hit him once, but as I was going to say, they can't really just go back to Roshan like a Drow lineup can. They struggle to take towers if Techies isn't right up in front, just constantly dropping landmines. At some point, DC will commence their slow siege. They're disrupting the Luna, they're stacking Ancients, he does have the Dominator. Once the Luna gets 1-2 items, Weeha gets a couple of items, he could be the one split pushing while they just sit behind the Luna. Can even use the Exile. There's a hook top, finally!
They got him in the remote mines to finish him off. It's one support kill, but at least it feels like so much more for Wings at this point.
Jesus, they had to work for that though. 15 and a half minutes before that combo connects.
Misery was actively farming the enemy jungle as well. Underneath an Observer Ward, that's how that was done. It just seems like they need an Observer Ward. They need to be having heroes out of position just for them to get those kills in a lot of instances.
I think Gem is the most important item for DC this game.
I'm going to hold off on building it for the time being. We'll see them just farm away. Misery now, again, building into that Harmlet, which is so good at keeping you alive. The rest of DC. I'm thinking about a smoke with Misery as well as Weeha and Soxa nearby. They'll do so and head towards that mid lane and try to at least get some vision down, but hopefully find a kill.
10,000 gold deficit. Deep hill to climb for Wings. Radiant Vision does scout out Shadow. They're still smoked. Senses it, Maud. Fire scan it did just clip resolution there for a second. Now they know.
Misery walking back through as well, so Wings are forced to go to the bottom side of the map, including their secret shop as well as hard camp there, and try to find farm in this bottom lane. But for now, there is more split push coming from Resolution, looking to use his waves and work on that tier 2 tower top lane. So again, more map control going the way of DC, unless Wings decide to maybe group up and fight. But right now, that doesn't seem to be the case. No smokes on anybody that I can see.
And DC can just siege very safely. Disrupt the Luna, she'll have Mantis soon. You can scout for the landmine traps if there were any. There's a couple remote mines around. Doesn't look like there's any. Oh, there is one remote mine trap in the trees, but just scout safely, siege safely, use forge spirits, poke. They don't have to commit bodies, and if they do want to throw a hero up there, they have the disruption and the X, so they have really good defensive capabilities to allow for a very organized and disciplined siege. And I imagine that's what we're going to see from DC moving forward.
Here we go. The remote mine's starting to be placed down on the high ground, so Dragon Lance might be an item the Luna wants to invest in at some point in time to at least stay a little bit safer. We have boots of travel now done. Let's see what the Naga Siren is dealing with. Shadow has arcane boots, 3,000 gold, so
he is
close to the
really rally. Poor at this point.
Yeah,
0-3.
He's very far behind.
98 CS. He's 40 CS down on a Luna. This goes back to the offensive tri-lane just completely self-destructing, and along with that DC taking early towers, it's limited the safe space on the map to farm. Naga just doesn't feel comfortable to go out on her own.
Naga Siren pretty far behind at this point. At 18 minutes in, you'd like to have a lot more. Now the Mantis Tower is done for the Luna. That's a no BKB, no Dragon Lance, just going to the straight Helm of the Dominator into the Mantis Tower, and has plenty of stacks to work with as well. So even more farm coming the way of the Luna, about to equip 10k net worth at this point. And there is that gem that you were talking about. Probably, like you said, the most important investment in this game for DC.
Now, you know, way back in the day, when nobody was playing Techies, before he was even introduced in Dota 2, he was a very popular hero in the Philippines, in Dota 1. And there was a Techie specialist, he stood in for a team in a tournament. He was playing really well, he actually went solo mid, he was dominating the game. The enemy team got a gem, but it was taken away. very quickly, like almost immediately after they got the gem. Difference in that game though was, like, the opponents needed the gem, because Techie still had his tower mid, he was still in complete control of the game. The hero was a bit scary as a map control hero. It was way before the changes to the landmines. They did a lot more damage in single instances, and at that point, losing the gem meant you couldn't deal with Techies. I don't really feel like this is that kind of game. This is more like, if you have gem, Techies really struggles to get anything done. So it's more of a bonus in this case. But yeah, you can see what I mentioned like 15, 20 minutes ago, that, you know, disruption illusions with the gem, the manta illusions with the gem.
Oh, the remote mines.
Lots of ways to scout, but you can't scout into the trees. So that's something DC will have to be cautious about. Good news is, they have someone that hates trees. It's Timber Song. Moo's just going to start shredding them.
Misery actually took a fair bit of damage from mines there. It felt like an old-timey story. I'm glad you shared that with us. That was pleasant.
Harkening back. Yeah. Killing oldest TI mode.
Enjoyed the brief story.
They also have ways to scout the PUDs, but as I said,
Revolution telling stuff. He's in trouble. Defensive disruption is not there in time. Ice will gladly give his life, but now Blink, he might have to give his as well. X-Mark back in the song. It'll stop everything. What a pickoff for Wings.
Heck, he's already back to base. DC giving up a kill there. I was going to say they have really good ways to scout the PUDs, but they didn't actually have a Forge Spirit back behind the tower. So I think in general when DC are sieging, really want to be sending an illusion or Forge Spirit constantly looking for the PUDs. They do have deep wards. It's not like they're not trying. That's something that should happen when you pick PUDs, is you should be able to at least occasionally find those hooks, catch someone off guard. Shadow Demon, no Force or Blink yet. That would be a really good choice for Soxa with that item. With either of those items, he could jump in and still save the Luna in that situation.
Just feels like it's a little too late though with that hook almost.
They need a lot more of that. Yeah. Like they ideally want to be finding one of those every time DC pushes. But now the tree clearing begins. DC gonna start a spot of dewarding here. They'll just send an illusion of Moo in to deal with these. Actually a pair. While bottom, Blink is setting up on resolution.
Misery.
He hits the arrow, big catch, and then he leaps in. Can he kill up resolution? He's a bit too tanky.
He's gonna come through resolution. I think the hook will finish him off. The ghost ship. Blink actually dodges it narrowly. The timing wasn't there. Now Misery's in trouble.
Alright, Zion's looking for a second kill. He's gonna get it. Nice pickoff by the punch, but he might save with his life. Moo guns him down, and now Morana forced to TP away. Just does bring him to mid lane for popping techies. Phase Beyond finally getting to drop landmines on towers for the first time this game.
A good start.
They're looking for Shadow.
If they find Shadow, he's TPing out. Weeha sees him. Cold Snap will come through the meatball. No song available this time. I don't think he had his, of course, Radiance completed.
He was close, though. That's a costly death. Really negates almost everything they achieved there.
Yeah.
Makes it a 2-for-2. Plays a key item timing. The Techie's Eggs is coming. And they do, I believe, now have the Morana BOTs, so pick up two big items, but DC with the Timber Saw, they just keep on clearing out trees, calmly plinking away traps, making sure there's nothing hidden around corners, and limit Wayne's ability to find those cheap little pickoffs.
Three or four there. Yeah, it looks like there were four there altogether. They killed one as well.
So what do you do now?
I mean, for Wings, you gotta keep this. Oh, they're gonna hook on Moo. That's what they do. And the Mystic Blade with the Ancient Seal, but he's still so tanked with the X marks coming in Ice Types again. Might get caught this time, LD.
BOT's in from the Morana. Wants to fight this. They don't kill the creep. Blink, though, still wants to back away, and DC chase forward.
He's gonna get caught by the torrent. Will that bring him down? It's the Demonic Purge that does so.
No suicide there. Gives up another kill. DC. Pickoff after pickoff, tower after tower, but they do find another. It doesn't really matter. Moo just chuckles. Now picked up the pipe. Further defensive capabilities against this one-hit combo that Wings have. And also a great way to deal with Morana and Radiance Burn. Really, if you look at Wings, it's almost all magic damage.
Yeah.
Late game, Morana could go into right-click drill, but she doesn't have the Drow Rager this time around to buff her up. Nice pick by Blink Bottom. Typing the Kunkka. Misery not able to armless toggle his way out.
They're gonna go to Roche right now, though. They're gonna try to contest this.
This is the Pudge dream. This is the Pudge dream, Mott. If ever there was a time for a Pudge to come up big, now is it.
DC will back out smartly. That Roshan was very dangerous, like you talked about. The hook, not to mention the song or an arrow coming through. Some serious damage. Blink and Fumarana leap out also is available, but now Blink has to use it.
DC should just be patient. Wings cannot rush. They don't need to rush now. They can wait until they have 5 alive, go in as a squad. The boat is an important component of their team fight. There's really no need to force a Roshan 4v5.
There's some wards that have been just placed down. It looks like DC will again counter ward them. This gem doing so much work this game, especially against that techie. They'll continue to put wards down of their own and gain map control. At the very least, Wings, they haven't needed to defend high ground yet. They haven't needed to put down those removed mines on the high ground. So, see how that transitions. And they will head back into Roche.
Yeah, still holding onto the gem on Mu. Still, as a result, able to keep up vision. They save Faith beyond, laying some traps. If he pokes too much closer, they could go. There's the hook!
They didn't get the Aegis from Resolution in time! The tornado
might save
the Suicide Squad! But he will end up staying alive! The Disruption keeping him up and ready to go! The Silence, the Arcane Bolt won't kill him! And they bring down 3!
There was a Naga Illusion in the pit there. I thought Shadow might be able to at least deny the Aegis, but even that wasn't possible. So 3 fall in the end. Song available. This might just be a farming Aegis for DC, honestly. I think they can go high ground, but I don't feel like Wayne's is getting stronger either. And you can see Moo just diving this Naga, has absolutely no fear. He's gonna force out the Song.
Yeah. That is a level 2 Song, but the Sunstrike, is it gonna do enough damage? Boom! Yes, it does! Weehawk gets the kill. Wow.
You see a draft like this on the main stage of TI, and yes, Wayne's like their unconventional picks, but you can only imagine they have practiced this, and it has worked before. The techie's instantly securing level 2 in the jungle to start the game, then he had stopped. It felt like they had a plan with the tri-lane. It just, DC, that early rotation for Misery, that to me was the key play that prevented Wayne's from getting momentum in the tri-lane, gave the Timbersaw a good start, and now begins the Disruption Illusion Siege. With Forge Spirits here, Wayne's need big hooks.
Oh.
It's gonna be tough though. There's an Aetherlens on Soxa now once he gets here, so he has better disruption range. He can also use the X on Misery if they want to send someone in safely for the chip damage.
Faithbeyond running low on mana right now. Only has about 3 mines set up in that trap to the right. You have Faithbeyond sitting back. Blink will jump in, look for a target. Hope they'll get an illusion instead. Tier 3 tower now down. This wave's starting to be chopped through. I've seen this before.
They gotta find a pickup soon, Mon.
Not finding anything just yet for Wings.
Oh, even the arrow missing. That could have been the Luna's death, maybe.
They get Mu on top of the line. They'll stay alive. He will fall.
That's the gem down.
The Eclipse coming through, doing some work. They have the Moonlight Channel, but it's too dead for Wings. Respawn from...
Mirana could do some work here, but already Timbersaw is back in.
Yeah. So quick. Plenty of charges, and it's a full set of racks, it looks like. I'll let the range creeps deal with, of course, that range Drax, and now they'll head to the top lane, get the tier 3 tower. X marks will come through, it'll be up onto the techies, he'll get caught with the torrent, the glaive's hitting him.
They can't even walk near the Rex, the bouncing glaive just hurt too much. DC, 2 lanes down, and no signs of stopping, they immediately rotate bottom. This pocket strategy has completely backfired.
Wings are just getting crushed in this game too. This, like you said, this pocket strategy, it's not accomplishing what they wanted. It comes down to that fairy fire as well as torrent in the beginning of the game. Now, not only a torrent, but a ghost ship coming through, allowing them to push even further in that.
It's over, Mon. GG, Wings get stomped. Down 20k gold. They never led this game with a Pudge, a Techies, and a pocket strategy. It's a gist didn't pan out. But credit to DC, they saw something unexpected, at least. I think the techies was unexpected. Not sure if the Pudge was. Wings have run it before. Adapted really well.
Yeah, I mean, there's not much really to talk about that game. It's just unfortunate, Wings, that, like you said, they might have tried that strategy before, and it more than likely worked. That's why they're bringing it out here on TI in the main stage. And of